I was recording them to tape because that's what I had, and I wanted to get them down quickly, and I liked the way they sounded. But it's not about, like, if you like the way something sounds, you don't think, well, I like the way this sounds because it's indie. I just like the way it sounds because I like the way it sounds. It's sort of like a feeling, you know. It's like if you like to, you know, if you like to be kissed on the cheek, you don't say, well, I like it because it's romantic. You say, I like it because I like the way it feels, right? And that's how it was with the tape. It's like I would listen back. I go, I like the way that sounds. That's what I'm going for. The thing is, like, you can't really think too hard about that. You do think too hard about it, but it's like not something you really want to. If you spend too much time doing that, you're going to lose sight of what's important, which is writing songs, right? It's like we moved in the studio because I wanted to work with Peter. You can't really record on a boombox with a bass. You can, but it doesn't sound good. And the point is, I thought the boombox recording sounded good. If I record solo into my boombox, that sounds good. If I record bass and guitar and vocal into the boombox, it doesn't sound good. It sounds terrible. I had heard his productions and they were good, and I knew he ran a studio down in Florida called Mana. I think the notion that people don't blend outside their their genres is a myth, right? That there's almost nobody is so genre bound that they only want to work with the kind of music they make. So we were in the middle of a session at Fidelitorium in North Carolina, Midge Easter studio, and we were watching this footage of Eric working with Cannibal Corpse during Evisceration Plague, and I was like, I should write to this guy, see if he's game to work with us. And he wrote back right away and said, oh yeah, I listen to all kinds of music and I love 4AD. You guys have been on 4AD, let's come out and work. And we came down, we did four songs with him. And what a quality human being and great engineer he is. It was just a real blast. When I was a child, I wanted to marry Judy Garland. It was like the first thing I told my parents about romance was like I saw The Wizard of Oz and she seemed, she had this presence and she had it in her from very early childhood. But then she was raised in show business, that's a hard place to be raised, right? And she survived, not very long, but her life is a story of survival. And if you grew up in that environment, then your life too is a story of survival. I'm a survivor of different things, but survivors can recognize in each other the same sort of cold, burning thing underneath them. And so I think that's what it's about. I mean, you always want new musicians coming in and sharing because it opens up new things in your core. But when we brought John Worster on for Heretic Pride, it really did feel like, you know, some final combo in one of those, you know, three lock combos had been turned, right? And that, like, we really work well together and we love playing music with each other so much. You know, it's like really, it's always a pleasure. It does make it so much easier to play the same song multiple times. I don't know how bands who have the same set list every night do it, because I couldn't do that. But we have some songs we've been playing forever. Once you're in the trio formation, they really start to open up, you know, and you really, every night, there's something new. I played South Plantation Road with the trio a million times, and every night I hear something new in what Worster's doing, you know, or when Peter says, ba-dum-dum, in the, like, eighth bar. Every night it snaps a little, with a little extra tang, and it's like, so that's, I mean, I think that trio is basic, right? We always want to bring new people in to sort of challenge and lift us. I'm a decent cook. You know, I cook for my wife. It's a big joy in my life. I mean, that would be the main one. I'm a pretty decent cook. I struggle to be a good person. You know, it's like that's where I started focus on most of my stuff. I'm a terrible house cleaner. I'm just not really reliable in that field. You know, and I don't say, so I wish I could say poet, but I think maybe I will have turned in four or five good poems by the time I die. I look up to the poets, right? But I'm a good cook. I make a samosa and knock you flat.